In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, brothers and sisters, to our celebration of the commemoration of the faithful departed. And as you know, this Mass is especially being offered for the deceased clergy of the diocese, deceased bishops, deceased priests, deceased deacons, asking the Lord to bring them into eternal life. So as we begin to celebrate this Mass, let's place our trust in Christ's redeeming love for each one of us and ask that we too may be made clean, may be prepared for the fullness of life. Lord, you are our light and our help. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are the stronghold of our life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You surround us with your love and compassion. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, glory of the faithful and life of the just, by the death and resurrection of whose Son we have been redeemed, look mercifully on your departed servants, that just as they profess the mystery of our resurrection, so they may merit to receive the joys of eternal happiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Job. Job said, "Ah, would that these words of mine were written down, inscribed on some monument, with iron chisel and engraving tool, cut into the rock forever. This I know, that my avenger lives, and he, the last, will take his stand on earth. After my awakening, he will set me close to him, and from my flesh I shall look on God. He whom I shall see will take my part. These eyes will gaze on him and find him not aloof." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Remember the good news that I carry. Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, sprung from the race of David. It is on account of this that I have my own hardships to bear, even to be chained like a criminal. But they cannot chain up God's news. So I bear all for the sake of those who are chosen, so that in the end they may have the salvation that is in Christ Jesus, and the eternal glory that comes with it. Here is a saying that you can rely on. If we have died with him, then we shall live with him. If we hold firm, then we shall reign with him. If we disown him, then he will disown us. We may be unfaithful, but he is always faithful, for he cannot disown his own self. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Now the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. I tell you most solemnly, unless a wheat grain falls on the ground and dies, it remains only a single grain. But if it dies, it yields a rich harvest. Anyone who loves his life loses it. Anyone who hates his life in this world will keep it for the eternal life. If a man serves me, he must follow me. Wherever I am, my servant will be there too. If anyone serves me, my Father will honor him. Now my soul is troubled. What shall I say? Father, save me from this hour? But it is for this very reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." A voice came from heaven. "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There's a certain fascination, I think, of wandering around old churchyards and reading the inscriptions on the headstones. I can't resist it. I have to go around looking just to see what they say. And you find some interesting ones. And there's one particular which really lodges in my memory. It said, remember me as you pass by, as you are now, so once was I. As I am now, one day you'll be. So stop and say a prayer for me. It's a simple verse, but highlighting something that I think I've always believed, particularly about the feast or the commemoration of All Souls. It's not simply a call to pray for our deceased loved ones, it's also the awakening of ourselves to our own mortality. As to the first point, the Church has always taught that it's a good and a wonderful thing to pray for the deceased. In addition, I feel it's good to pray for our loved ones too. We Catholics have great devotion to the saints, such as St. Anthony, St. Jude, St. Therese. We all have our own particular favourite saints. But what about our own saints? The ones who are unofficially canonised, if you like parents, siblings, and other loved ones. If we believe in faith that God is everywhere and that our loved ones are with God, then they're everywhere also. They become our very special intercessors with God in the communion of saints. I found that the losses in my own family particularly and friends become less painful when I keep that relationship alive, if you like, through communication. For example, even now I talk to my mother and my father throughout the course of every single day, sharing my life, asking for their blessings for myself and others, and thanking them for, if you like, the small miracles that I've received. And I've always been comforted by the post-resurrection gospel scenes where Jesus appears to his friends. This shows me that relationship continues even into the next life. As to the second point, the awakening to our own mortality, I found again that communication with those who've gone before us makes the thought of death less fearful. In fact, psychologists tell us that the fear of dying is a normal human fear. I once heard of a man, incidentally, who was so fearful of dying that he became a real hypochondriac and was anointed so many times that in the end he had to go to the dermatologist to treat his oily skin. But back to the awakening. I remember the reading once a story about two priests who were from a communist country. Both men had experienced similar terrifying torture and punishments during their years of imprisonment. But their most painful suffering occurred when, on a given evening, each was told, "This is your last meal. Tomorrow you die." The following morning, they were led out before a firing squad, blindfolded, and then trembled as they heard the command, "Ready, aim, fire." How stunned they were to discover that they were still alive. The soldiers had been ordered to shoot above the heads of the two priests. And the communist guards repeated this charade many, many times during the period of the next 10 months. And what most of all touched me in reading this story was that the two men actually began to befriend Sister Death, as St. Francis called her. They had no more fear of death. But even more inspiring was their willingness to forgive their captors and their ability to live joyfully in the present moment. Both of these men were fully alive where God is dwelling in the now, this moment of their lives. It's so easy for us to crucify ourselves between the two thieves of regrets for our yesterdays and fears for our tomorrows. In living that way, we miss being present to and receiving the strength from our God who lives and loves us in the moment that we call now, in this present moment. How blessed are we and all souls who are so loved. We'll stand for the prayers of the faithful. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, the bishops and all who lead the Church, that they will proclaim joyfully the hope we hold in the resurrection. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For peace and reconciliation between nations and peoples, that they will turn away from war and violence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our brothers who serve the Church as bishops and priests, that they may be given a place in the liturgy of heaven. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us ask Mary, Mother of the Church, to join her prayers with ours as we say,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen.
God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers, bishops, priests, and deacons. Cleanse them and all the faithful departed of their sins, and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Almighty and merciful God, by means of these sacrificial offerings, wash away, we pray, in the blood of Christ, the sins of your faithful departed, and purify unceasingly by your merciful forgiveness those you once cleansed in the waters of baptism. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Your resurrection.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession, in your presence, we rely from failing.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Terence Patrick, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Saviour's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Have mercy on us, Lamb of God.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
thank you.
Let us pray. Having received the sacraments of your only begotten Son, who was sacrificed for us and rose in glory, we humbly implore you, O Lord, for your departed servants, that cleansed by the paschal mysteries, they may glory in the gift of the resurrection to come, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother bishops, priests, and deacons in the sure hope and the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon them in this life, for the service they have given to the Diocese of Middlesbrough. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and strengthen our hope that all our departed brothers and sisters will share in his resurrection with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Through Christ, who became like us in all things but sin, let us pray for those who have died. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen. May the souls of the faithful departed rest in peace. Amen. May the angels lead us into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome us and lead us into the holy city of Jerusalem. The Lord be with you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Our help is in the name of the Lord. May Almighty God bless you, Father, and the Son,